Hi everybody, it's Sandy here in the Rosie Temple in Cadnam in Hampshire in England, and it's taken a while to get this set up this evening because everywhere I seem to go with my Facebook Live BT broadband, in its wisdom, wasn't strong enough to support a live reading. So I've been carrying this, carrying my phone around the house, trying to find somewhere where I was going to get a good enough signal. And it's obviously going to be a call to BT in the morning. But anyway, welcome. It's the evening of the new moon eclipse. And I hope you've been able to navigate these extraordinary energies, these extraordinarily intense energies that this time is seemingly offering us, that your Sunday has had some positive vibes to it, and you're easing your way into the evening. That's if you're in the UK, of course. Today it's just been an extraordinary, it's been an extraordinary week. In my experience, and some very, very intense experiences during the week that were really designed to catapult me, if you like, into this place of release and letting go. And I think for many of us, this is really what the essence of this particular eclipse has been for us. You know, last year was 2016 was a challenging year for many of us, with a lot of intensity and some very interesting places to navigate. And then moving into 2017, there really has been, I sense, a deep calling within us to find the right places within us to carry us forward, a real sense of purification. You know, what is it that we really signed up for, and what are we here for and standing for at this point in our journey? And yes, from that place, of course, of letting go, there is the potential for there to be space for something new to come in. And it feels to me that it's, you know, it's a very rapid switch. Once we are prepared to let go of the old story, once we're prepared to let go of a situation or a pattern that really doesn't serve us and doesn't feel like it's a life enhancing experience, then we somehow are given the courage and the strength to say, okay, this it's done. You know, this is time, and this is time for something new to come forward. And certainly, it seems that once we have prepared and we are with that program, that it's quite straightforward for us in that process of letting go, of saying, okay, this is now I open to the new, And this has been certainly been my experience this week, just incredibly difficult things to deal with, but a point at which there is a switch and a birthing of something new that I'm pretty excited about, actually, and I will share more as it incubates and as it takes more form. So we're in a different part of the Rosie Temple this evening, and today here has been a really magical day. I'll show you one of the beautiful roses that I've been working with today in creating some Way of the Rose essences. And it just has been a fabulous process. I've worked with an amazing essence master or mistress, Sharon Keenan, and it's just been a real gift to be able to work with someone in ceremony and working with that kind of level of work to create these magical essences that are taking us really through from that fifth dimensional field and opening up into a 12th dimensional field of frequency. So they are just extraordinary. And I actually, it's what it's so lovely to do this reading is that I'm actually sat in the Rose Temple with the grid that we've got set up here, and these amazing essences, amazing energies that are just sitting and imbibing in the energy of the temple. So, shall we look at the roses and see what sense they have to offer us in this next phase? And it was interesting because I had thought that I was going to do this reading this morning, but the guidance was that we needed to have gone through this eclipse window because, you know, most of us working with these sort of energies knew of the eclipse portal, and it's like, yeah, but then what? You know, what are we looking to build on? What are we looking to incubate? What are we looking to take forward? So, the roses said that they would like to be way showers and guides for that new energy as we go into, it's a 6 month window that we have now between the eclipses that we've had in February to that sort of the closing out of that window, which will be in August. So let's see which one is drawing you. So is it rose card one? Rose card two or rose card three? So if you were drawn to rose card one, here she is, and she's rose nine. Now rose nine was one of the original roses that came through from the imprint from the Alhambra, and she is just a stunner. She sits on the solar plexus when I'm working with her, and she says, don't mess with me, you know, I have good boundaries, I'm very clear about who I am, and I radiate, I hold the place of the wise woman, I hold the wisdom keeper energy here. And so, you know, she's what I would call the Sekhmet of roses, you know, she's like really, really clear, holds very good boundaries, holds her strength. There's such a power in here. There's nothing fluffy about this rose. You know, she is really a feminine warrior energy, and just stunning to work with. So if she's called you today, if you were drawn to rose card one, she's really calling you to look at all of those places where you really need to make sure that you've got very good boundaries, and you stand in your power. This rose is calling you to stand in your power and to be able from that place to speak your truth and be fully present here. Really, you know, it's a solar plexus. This is a very solar rose. You know, she holds that very strong radiance of the sun, very clear. She's really clear rose. And this is this place of, when, you know, when it, this know thyself and to thine own self be true. This is really her essence. So beautiful rose to choose. And I see Jilly is here. Hi, Jilly. Hi, Sam. You know, lovely to share these roses with you. And I think Ellie's here as well. So, yes, beautiful. So if you chose rose card two, here she is, and she's rose angel three. Now, any of you that are doing this rose angel journey with me will know that this was a rose that we were working with just this last week. And she's just great, really clear rose to work with. She works with the Ajna, the third eye, and is the transformer, the angel of forgiveness. So if you chose rose card two, she's calling you to look at all of those places where you can release through forgiveness. And what I've found for myself, particularly in this last few weeks, is the more that we are able to forgive, the more powerful this rose is. So this place of being able to come to this place of forgiveness. Now, this rose actually was one that I photographed in New Jersey in one of the rose sisters on the classes, Ellie Corder. She has got a lot of roses in her garden, and this was called a knockout rose. And you can see actually that she's got her sort of like her arms round in almost like she's hugging herself. She's almost like hugging her golden heart because she's very open. But there is a place in which she offers herself protection. She offers herself comfort. And I think this place has a voice of knowing that we can self-resource. And that actually takes away a lot of the projection that we have on others. So coming into this place of forgiveness and being able to forgive not just from the head, but from the heart. The head forgiveness is it's a mental construct. What we have to do is to come down to this heart field place and really know that everybody is doing their best. And when people behave in a certain way, it's from their own conditioning, it's from their own pain and their own suffering that is the trigger for their own behaviours. It's actually nothing to do with us. And so coming to this place of forgiveness and coming to the place of seeing the bigger picture and seeing the fact that the suffering of another is creating a particular field of behaviour for them, and there's an internal issue that's going on. And so that doesn't mean that we don't have good boundaries. And this is what, of course, this rose is saying. She's, it's like, I have good boundaries. I have discernment. I have qualities of inner power. But this rose is saying, forgiveness is a key here. And I think the more I've come to look at this, the more I've come to realize that forgiveness is the second most powerful place that we can work through to love. Love is the key always here. What would love do now? But forgiveness is the way that actually takes us to that place. And when we can't find that place in us to forgive another or to forgive ourselves, it perpetuates the story. So here she is, Rose Angel 3. And if you chose Rose Card 3, she is Rose Angel 7. And Rose Angel 7 works on the solar plexus, and she is the transformer of betrayal to trust. So we've got two Rose Angels in the reading today. So this is calling us to really, really embody the qualities. Oh, thank you for all the hearts. Some lovely hearts going through past the past the screen. So this rose has always struck me as being quite interesting because she, there's this beautiful chalice, but it's like she's got trainer wheels on, like you have on a child's bike that stabilizes, that actually hold the balance and hold us through this place of really, really being able to trust ourselves, trust our inner wisdom, trust our inner guidance, to be such a powerful way in which we can hold ourselves steady and step forward in this place of fully, fully trusting ourselves. So if she called you today, if you were drawn to Rose Card 3, look at all of these areas of trust, how you approach this place of really trusting the wisdom within, trusting the voice within to be your ultimate guide, to be your, for her to hold your hand really, and be able to affirm for you that actually this is all there is. You know, learning to trust our gut feeling, learning to trust our emotions, learning to trust our instincts is the only place where we are inner resourced, where we have that inner place of guidance. Security isn't outside of ourselves, but when we can trust what it is that is our inner tutor, our inner tuition, then we can fly. Truly, we can fly. So, our three roses this time, that it was showing us in this window between now and the August eclipses, are to really work with the solar plexus, to trust ourselves fully, and to hold that solar energy. This is a solar plexus. This is a perfect place to do sunbathing from. If you can breathe in and out from the solar plexus to the heart, to the solar rays, you will really, really feel the power and the strength that the sun can offer. And also, of course, the solar plexus and the heart are so connected. This is the place of the authentic feminine warrior energy in both men and women. But it's where our gut wisdom and our heart truth come together, so that we really... everything's in alignment, you know, that we are authentic in our feelings and our what we say. So I think the thing that's come for me over the weekend, it's like that alignment of thought, word and action, that all of those things need to line up for us so that we are totally in flow. And in that alignment with the universe, with the universal energies. This one, which was card two, which is talking about truth and forgiveness, being in that place where we can fully forgive, where we can forgive ourselves, and we can forgive others. And the third card again. The Rose Angel 7. So this is the one that really helps us to understand and to trust our gut wisdom. Powerful rose. This rose actually is a David Austin rose. Very scented rose. Has almost like a scent of myrrh. It's an unusual rose. It's called Woolerton Old Hall. And actually in... she came up this colour when in the print, in the photograph, but actually she's a lot more sort of old, an old cream colour, but a really beautiful rose, very, very powerful. So there you go. Those are the three roses that we're working with in this upcoming period. And I find it really interesting that actually the second rose is very much to do with the Ajna, the centre of higher will, and both Rose 9 and Rose Angel 7 are both to do with the solar plexus. So that's our personal will and how we activate the insight that we get in, the download, if you like, that we get in through the third eye. And the third eye for me is the combination of the pineal gland and the pituitary gland, and it weaves together the Ajna and the forehead chakras, so they come into unison into the third eye. And powerful energy on that particular chakra. It's known as the master chakra, governs the endocrine system and the balance of the body. So we're being really called to... you know, to really stand in our power, to walk our talk, to be authentic, in how we show up in the world, in thought and word and action. So I hope that's been an interesting journey for you. And just to say, the Rose Angel course that we've been running for the, well, we're into week five tomorrow, this week coming, I've had such fabulous feedback for this journey with the Rose Angels. It's been a stunning one, and we will be repeating that. But also to say that there's some new adventures coming up for this coming period, coming into the summer, and I'm going to be taking a group to the Alhambra in Spain, in Granada, Spain, at the end of April. It's a study stroke retreat. It is not a tour. The whole idea is that we are able to really be in the energies of that Venusian temple imprint that is why the Alhambra is where it is. And so there'll be details of that coming up next week. Again, the guidance was to wait until this eclipse window was out of the way before putting things out on this fresh energy. And I'm also going to be taking a trip to Chartres Cathedral, just southwest of Paris, a study tour into the mysteries and the mystery school that was Chartres. And I'm also taking a trip up to Rosslyn. So for those of you that are interested in sacred sites and how they move the energy within the body, how you connect with the site and how the energies and the information come through, do look out for the website. And I've also got some new classes that are coming through, and they will be up shortly. They're coming in on the imprint of this this new moon eclipse. And as I say, I sit here and I in the Rosy Temple this evening, surrounded by the most amazing rose essences and these beautiful roses that have been gracing the temple and the grid in our work today, and the way of the rose essences. And I've got some really, really exciting things to share in this next coming couple of weeks. So thank you so much for joining me. I can see Babita's there and Ashley. I think Linda's there as well. I'm really grateful that you should join me this evening, and wishing you much love and rosy blessings as you move into this this new energy that the eclipse windows offered us. And may all that you have called forward in this this eclipse be effortlessly manifested for you. So with much love and rosy blessings on your journey, until next. Bye for now. Bye-bye.